Welcome to State of Tech. Let's take a look at customizing the nav bar on your Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus. So go ahead and swipe down from your notifications, and we're going to go into our settings. We're going to come into display, and we're going to swipe down to the bottom until we see navigation bar. Tap in there, and then we can customize our nav bar. The first area is going to have a show and hide button on our nav bar. Now, whenever we're inside an application, we can actually hide the nav bar so we can take full advantage of this nice, tall, beautiful display. So all we have to do is double tap on that button to the left-hand side of the nav bar, and it's going to hide our nav bar. And now to get back to the nav bar, we swipe up from the bottom of the screen, and it's going to show. And it's going to hide after a little bit of time. Now the nav bar will always be present on your home screen, so you see if I go home, there is no option of hiding the nav bar in the home screen, but if I were to jump into any other application, you see the nav bar automatically hides out of the way once I jump into an app, and I have to swipe back up to get back into it. Now coming back into the settings, if I didn't want that to be an option, I can always tap on the button here and disable that show and hide button, and my nav bar will always be present no matter what application I'm in. Now below that we have background color. I can tap in any one of these colors and it's going to change the color of the nav bar. Now this color will always be present on any of the full screen apps, but you notice if I go home, that color is no longer there. It's kind of more of a transparent nav bar on the home screen. Now down below the background color, we actually have hard press home button. So the home button actually has some sort of pressure sensitivity behind it, and we can actually adjust the sensitivity that we can use to press the home button. We just use the slider here. We can also do a pressure test. So all you have to do is kind of press the home button, and you can see the more that you press down, the harder you press down, you get a little bit of vibration feedback, and we're filling in this kind of button. So now if I wanted to, I can do stronger, and so this is going to be actually activating the home button, and each time I adjust it, I am actually having to push the home button down a little bit harder each time. And notice the actual circle kind of gets larger as we go stronger as well, and when you press it down, you're seeing the actual circle fill up with the amount of pressure that you're applying. If you don't want to be able to hard press the home button, just go ahead and turn that off, and that option is no longer there. And whenever you press the home button, there's no sort of pressure sensitivity behind it now for different options. Now below that, we can actually unlock with the home button, and this is not available when hard press home button is off. So we need to turn that back on, and now the unlock with home button is available. So what this does is whenever I lock my device, I can actually hard press on the home button to wake my device up. And if I have any sort of biometric lock screens enabled, such as the face scanning iris scanner or even the fingerprint reader, it's going to allow me to quickly enable that without having to actually swipe up on my screen or press the power button to actually wake my device up. And the last area, which I think is really cool, is the button layout. Right now, we have it set up for recents, home, and then back from left to right. If we wanted to, we can actually have it be back, home, and then recents. This is more reminiscent of the actual Nexus devices or the Pixel devices. This is how the home buttons are set up on Google's devices, and some people might prefer it that way. It's more of the way that I'm accustomed to, coming from more of the Pixel devices. I like the stock Android feel, so I like having the home buttons in this order. Samsung has always had it in the opposite layout. It's just something they've always done, so that's why the software buttons come default in this layout. But if you wanted to make things a little bit easier, you could always come back in here and do back, home, and then recents, and keep them in that order. So that is how you customize your navigation bar on your Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus. If you found this video useful, be sure and give it a thumbs up. Be sure and subscribe to State of Tech for more videos like this, and we'll see you in the next one.